Hi, my name is Raymond Maloney from SCS Railways. I'm the Senior Project Manager here with us at Copthall. We progressed quite well throughout 2024 since you've last been here. You can see our derailment walls are now being built. We have our walkway walls on either side for the downline and the upline, which are progressing through the 880 metre long tunnel. Since you've last been here, we've completed two more vent shafts and we are well on our way with our fourth and starting to move through on the roofs past our fifth vent stack, and we are on target to complete the central section of Copthall Tunnel by the end of 2024, meaning we can focus on the eastern end of the tunnel through the early 2025 to work towards completion and eventually connecting with Gatemead Embankment and completing the trace to the West Ruislip portal. And obviously behind me here at the back of the eastern portal, Dominique has installed successfully 1,000 segments and has completed constructing the Colne Valley Viaduct, and now we continue the journey towards West Ruislip portal. As you enter from the eastern end through the eastern portal into the central section, which is 550 metres long, we have five vent stacks, which are at 100 metre intervals. The rationale behind the vent stacks is to allow the train to continue at line speed and not build any pressure up on the front of the train. As the train continues in at line speed, it begins to build a bulb of pressure in front of it, and these vent shafts allow the pressure being built up in front of it to go up and be released into the atmosphere. Another interesting fact here at Copthall, where I'm standing at the moment, we are roughly 27 metres underground now that we've completed the backfill above.
My name's Dan Townsend. I'm an agent working on the West Ruislip and Gatemead Embankment. In this area, we're building embankments, and that is to connect the portal where we've got the London tunnels, and that connects us all the way up to the other end where we've got the Copthall cut and cover tunnel. Where we're stood now on the West Ruislip train embankment, we're about 6 metres above where we were a couple of years ago. At the foundations, we improved the natural ground with a series of stone columns. Across the site, we've installed about 7,500 of those, and that's essentially just to improve that existing ground. Behind me, behind that bridge, in the distance is the West Ruislip portal. Also, and what we're stood on, is the West Ruislip retained embankment, and then ahead of me in the distance is the Gatemead embankment. So that's a total of 800 metres long, comprising of 12 different types of material to build those embankments. A unique feature about these high-speed rail embankments is transition zones. So essentially what they do is reduce the forces of the train as it goes from the stiff structures either side of us to the softer embankment like what we're stood on now. Not only does this improve passenger comfort, it also reduces the stresses on the track, the structures, the embankment, and just improves overall performance and safety of that embankment and the trains. So we've moved over to the Gatemead embankment now. So we're pretty much stood exactly where the trains are going to be running as they come out of London and head into the Copthall Tunnel behind me and head towards Birmingham. We're now in our final stages of building these embankments. So over the coming weeks, next few weeks, we'll actually complete these structures and we will finally be able to see the trace and the line of exactly where the train is going to go, connecting all the bridges, all the structures and all the tunnels together. Once the earthworks are complete on all of these embankments, we'll be moving into installing the permanent drainage for the embankments themselves and the surrounding areas, the landscaping of all of these embankments. We'll also be installing noise barriers along the full route of these embankments to connect the two tunnels. So over the last 4 years, we've installed 7,500 stone columns. We're edging closer to completing our 350,000 tonne of aggregate in these embankments. And I look forward to updating you in the future.